My name is Izu, and I've lived in the Haight-Ashbury community for 30 years, and I'd love to introduce you to one of my best friends in the world, a neighbor of mine, lives right around the corner, William Francis Sheehan, also known to the community as Waterfall.
Thank you, Izu.
Hello, Water.
How are you doing today?
Good.
So you're going to ask me about my middle name, which is...
Francis.
Francis, my folks... somehow knew I'd wind up out here in the city of St. Francis. Bless them, they were lovers of the Golden Rule, and I give them all that honor. And, so we're talking about I look upon it, Rebecca, as kind of 65 to 75, and then as 95 to now. Okay, what's the parallels? What's the differences? So here's my little joke. What was the great oxymoron of the period of what the society calls the Vietnam era, but what I look upon as the golden age of communal experimentation and a transformation of society that was beginning? So what was the great oxymoron of that period?
I don't know, what was it?
Military intelligence.
There you go.
See, you did remember.
In our
present dilemma period, 95 to 205, what is the great oxymoron of this period of history?
Same thing.
No. Corporate culture. The experiments of the period, I took an easier way for me to express myself.
Okay.
Because I like to express my generation, our generation.
Mm-hmm.
Many of us chose not to go to war. And we'll just talk America. The world has its own history.
Okay.
But we're like the big gorilla in the room, being the United States, that no one can really ignore for very long, the elephant in the china shop, as it were. So the society at large that thinks of it as the Vietnam War era has never honored the people who, for whatever reason, decided not to go to war. So I would say to our contemporaries that I honor you.
I
honor anyone who stood for peace and to find a way. We still have the same dilemma. You might even ask me what the dilemma is.
What is the dilemma?
I think it is, Isu, that the love of power is still amongst us. And I do see somewhere as the power of love shall prevail. The greatest dilemma of it all is that the people that want to run other people's lives mm-hmm. are the ones least worthy to do so.
Absolutely.
And the people that honor the Golden Rule, as yourself and many of us, it's not as if the Golden Rule is a hidden secret.
Mm-hmm.
It's love your neighbor as yourself.
Exactly.
Treat each person as you would wish them to treat you. Mm-hmm. It's not exactly like it's been a secret all these years.
Right.
So to speak to the young people coming of age right now, I would say at least take heart and hope. You do not have to go to war. When the young stop going to war, and some of our contemporaries, and I mean contemporaries, the people who are the very same age we are,
mm-hmm.
are busy right now ruining the world.
Mm-hmm.
You're supposed to ask me, did you say running the world?
Did you say running the world or ruining the world?
Well, I think I said ruining the world. And you know, what I mean by that is those are the people for whom the love of power has become their raison d'etre, to quote the French, and you know, how many raisins does any one person need? And the greed is not, you know, in the '80s it was, greed was good. Corporate culture, when I say it's an oxymoron, mm-hmm. I mean it's good for oxes and morons, mm-hmm. but it's not good for the human race as a whole. The human race as a whole needs vision and needs peace, and most of us can accept and understand that. We're going through a difficult period where the people who have desired this power their whole lives mm-hmm. are now in their maturity, and they seem to own everything. Which I truly believe, it was an old saying in the 60s that we were in the belly of the beast.
Yes.
Now we've been swallowed up, regurgitated, and pooped out so often that we don't really know where we are anymore in some regards. But it's not a lasting vision. Mm-hmm. The people of the world, I believe, need a bit more. So we created many things in the interim. That's why I say 65 to 75, because there was a golden age on the West Coast, Lou Gottlieb and Morningstar and Bill Wheeler at Wheeler's Ranch and the great communes of Taos and the Hog Farm and New Buffalo and throughout the world. During that period, there was great experimentation.
What was the New Buffalo?
New Buffalo is a commune that it's featured in Easy Rider. It's along the banks of the Rio Grande. It was one of the great communes of the communal period, as I like to call it, mm-hmm. rather than the war period, okay? These are all up and down the West Coast. It was Tolstoy Farm. Lou Gottlieb was a person who will always be dear to me. Lou taught me something that I would like to share with you.
Please do.
And that was that he had never worked a day in his life. And a lot of people said, well, you were the piano player for the Limelighters, and that's pretty rough touring with a band. And he did all the musical arrangement. And he said, okay, what I meant was, I never did anything for gain that I wouldn't have done for the love of it. Mm-hmm. So in his opinion, he had never... So he and Rena, his beautiful young wife, bought some choice land up in Sonoma County, part apple orchard, part redwoods in the back, and they deeded it to God. They said it was open land, and the word went out to the diggers of the Haight-Ashbury, who were baking bread right over here at All Saints Church, and bringing it down to the Panhandle, and groups like the Grateful Dead would come down and play while people jumped through the free frame of reference and shared and cared for each other. And I don't think that 60s was the only renaissance. There was probably the gay 90s and the roaring 20s and many, many others throughout history. And I think we're long due for another one right about now.
So that's the
plea or the understanding to the young people coming of age now is, you don't choose to follow these old dinosaurs into their wars. It's the same war, and there's one thing I cannot say in a happier, humorous way at all. My generation, I saw many of my generation turn up missing or maimed,
yes.
And it's happening again.
Yes.
So does this mean that in our whole lifetimes that we've learned nothing? Mm. But does it mean that maybe it's time for the people who are ruining the world to grow up themselves and step aside. I mean, they're selling security, mm-hmm. but they're selling a very aggressive and harmful form of it. And we would be much more secure. There was a point where the whole world would have embraced the United States if we'd have chosen a peaceful way of resolving conflict. So I still do look. So the young people hold the key to that. It's happening right now, as a matter of fact. One of the legacies of the 60s was no more forced draft. There are men like myself, that was forced conscription. Now at least there's a choice. So any young person, 14 to 24 or whatever, right now, is watching or is listening, get a waterfall in. Get a waterfall in. Have some, make some of your own art, and don't go to war. That's.
Well, I'd like to read something right under the waterfalling, and it says, "When free thought is outlawed, only outlaws will think." And that's what it's all about. This is a quarterly paper that Waterfall puts out in the Haight-Ashbury. Quarterly, right? Is it monthly or quarterly?
It comes out when the pages are complete,
okay.
Along with my neighbor, my wonderful artist neighbor, David Wills, who did these beautiful, this was the original Haight Street Fair poster. This is a rendition of this, of the Haight as an island of beauty and visionary hope. And this is a new piece from Buster Fleming of a river and a waterfall. And we've not been resting. We've Eco over here and yourself, we've done many rainbow gatherings through the years. Again, something out of the mainstream that people don't recognize, but it has a wonderful value in self-liberation, liberating, and in returning our connectedness to each other and to nature.
Exactly.
So may we all fly like eagles.
May we all fly like eagles.
Flying so high.
Flying so high.
Circling the universe.
Circling the universe.
On wings of pure light.
On wings of pure light.
Oyate Wikaho.
I didn't get that part.
Oh, it's Yichayo.
Oh, Yichichayo.
May we all fly like eagles.
May we all fly like eagles.
Flying so high.
Flying so high.
Circling the universe.
Circling the universe.
On wings of delight.
On wings of delight.
Oyate Wikaho.
Oyate Kiyaho.
Oh, Yichichayo.
Oh, Yichichayo.
May we all fly like eagles.
May we all fly like eagles.
Flying so high.
Flying so high.
Circling the universe.
Circling the universe.
On wings of pure light.
On wings of pure light.
Oyate Wikaho.
Oyate Kiyaho.
Oh, Yichichayo. Let me teach. Here's one. I'd like to teach this song.
Edit that part.
No, it's okay.
I have a terrible voice.
It's okay. It's an unfamiliar word. Think of it as a chorus of thousands. Here's one you get immediately, and I urge you.
Do I have to sing along?
Well, it's so easy. And this song, if you listen, you can learn it instantly.
Okay.
You've got peace like a river. Peace like a river. Peace like a river in your soul. Peace like a river. Peace like a river. Peace like a river in your soul. You've got joy like a fountain, joy like a fountain, joy like a fountain in your soul. Joy like a fountain, joy like a fountain, joy like a fountain in your soul. You've got love like an ocean, love like an ocean, love like the ocean in your soul. Love like the ocean, love like the ocean, love like the ocean in your soul.
Much better without me joining in.
I
don't want to be go down in history as the worst singer in San Francisco, okay?
You go down in history as the one that tried the hardest.
That tried the hardest, exactly.
Right here, sing along. This is a little. Oh, June 12th, come to the Haight Street Fair.
Absolutely.
Come early and hear calls to the seven directions. You know, there's seven directions. Most people think there's...
I thought there was four.
You thought there was four?
Yes.
There is actually seven. There is, of course, the north, south, east, and west.
Yes.
But then there is also above.
Mm-hmm. Below.
Below. And within.
And within.
So we're in a small space. We're not outdoors. So let me try the call for the within.
Okay. Okay, now, where were you since we've been talking about the 60s and the 70s and the 80s and the 90s and 2005? Where were you in 1967?
In engineering school.
Oh,
sorry, what? Don't ask me about 68.
What happened in 68?
What didn't happen in 1968? And I mean that in all seriousness.
Okay.
It gives me chills. There's a book out now. My sister is reading this. Kathleen is reading this book called 1968, Rebecca. And what didn't happen? One of the nice things about that period of time is I went from being an engineer right through the rabbit hole, just like Dorothy, to being in the stratosphere, you know. One of my low tech jokes. You want to hear another of my low tech jokes? I have no cell phone, nor do I hear one ringing. But thanks to the bear, I'm a cellular being. I have no cell phone, nor I need to hear it ringing. But thanks to the psychedelic 60s, I've been a cellular being. But Lord, I don't even want to remember. There was a period, that period of time, and I know Rebecca felt the same way. It's like many lifetimes in that year alone. Mm-hmm. Many lifetimes in that year alone. I feel like I'm a different person, turned inside out so many times. And
In which way?
Well, in very good ways, in ways that have stayed with me, that I can honestly give hope to people and say there is a better way than the old dinosaurs who are ruining the earth. Right. Did I say running the earth?
Yes, you did. I meant to say, yes, I know.
But again, you know, that is a joke. I have no right to judge anyone. Everybody has different factors. I'll give you a quick history lesson since there's time to spare. Everything that has ever happened falls into what is known as inevitable. Are you following me?
Yes.
So, therefore, there is no sense lamenting about how we got here. Our only proper life raft function is to go on. I think we were all together a year ago when Ramdas said that if we're still here, we're still part of this solution, as it were. And so therefore the dinosaurs who are ruining the world are also my contemporaries. Mm-hmm. As a matter of fact, Bill Clinton graduated college the same year I did, and I think George Bush got thrown out of college the same year I did. But, you know, hey, I partied a little too, you know? And everybody
was... did inhale, right?
His brother did, I can tell you that, because I handed him the doobie. Roger did, that's for sure. But so did Georgie. And the funny, you know, the ironies of it are why you don't judge people. Bush didn't go to Vietnam. Not because he doesn't believe in hurting people, but at least he didn't go. For whatever reason.
Right.
Al Gore is the Boy Scout.
Right.
And the common wisdom, and there is this going on in the United States, which I don't like because it reminds me of the old Stalinist thing. Mm-hmm. The common wisdom is that you were better if you went to war and then realized it was a crappy war, at least for my generation. Mm-hmm. and they're still trying to foster that. However, the young right now have an option, and apparently they're starting to exercise it en masse. And one of the movements, as the 60s were so many movements swirling together, the movement for civil rights, the movement for treat women with equality, the movement to treat nature with equality, they all swirl together into that beautiful psychedelia of we were all like a one being for a while. And so we need to restore that. And to the old dinosaurs ruining the earth, I just say, step aside, let your children take care of you. Don't be afraid all the time. Mm-hmm. Don't be so judgmental. There are other ways of looking at things.
Right.
The dogmatism is a form of fear. It's a trap for the mind.
Right.
Anybody who finds themselves embracing a dogmatism that is exclusive of other people, let me at least warn you, you're trapping your own mind, and a mind is a terrible thing to trap. And I don't think the young people, one thing I will say to my own, about myself that I like, is I have never looked down on any generation coming of age. I don't, you know, Tom Brokaw's fine. My folks went through World War II, but he thinks that they're the greatest generation, but they didn't like it, and they told me so. That's what I mean by inevitable. The conditions for what's going to unfold are happening right now, today. If the youth of America and the world say no to continuing the war, and we of the mature generations who have said no all along, but we kind of have to keep our voice down, don't we? Because it's never really been acceptable that I refuse to go to Vietnam.
Right.
You know, I it's okay, and we're kept here for entertainment purposes by
right.
the corporate state or whatever. But you know, I don't want to serve that. I don't want to serve divisiveness in any way.
I have a question. Why do you live in the Haight-Ashbury? You live in San Francisco. Why have you chosen to stay in the Haight-Ashbury and live here? Why is it your home? How do you think of it as your family? Why are you comfortable in the Haight-Ashbury?
Because of people like you, mostly, Rebecca. Because of the beauty of the town. But I think I was there was a period I was more comfortable on the road, helping put on rainbow gatherings, being in a different forest all the time, and exploring the world. And there was another time where I have a favorite cave in New Mexico, in the Jemez Mountains. My nearest neighbors were up on a roof where a family of porcupines. You know what porcupines are, of course.
Yeah, of course. An animal. You're talking about the animal.
Well, I mean, ask me, what are porcupines?
What are porcupines?
They're like raccoons with quills. Okay. They were good neighbors. You know, and I was happy there, but I missed the ocean. I was born in a harbor town, and I really do believe in the vision of creating a peace monument on the ruins of the old Alcatraz. Mm-hmm. And
that's where this comes in.
And this, yes.
Talk
yes.
about this painting.
This is a painting by my friend David, who helps me produce the waterfall in. Wonderful gentleman. Like that?
Yeah. There's actually an oil of this.
So, yes, this is from an oil painting. But he used me as a model for, we want a statue of a male figure to complement the Statue of Liberty, facing to Asia as the Statue of Liberty faces Europe, the old world and the new, and a peace university. If you look here, it says University of Peace, on the ruins of the old Alcatraz. Rebuild it, leave it as it is, and just use that as a base for a university of peace where people could come from all around the world and stay at the Presidio. And right now the Starfleet is negotiating to rent the space out.
Wow. Just let us know when they're coming.
That's beautiful.
They're already here.
Yeah,
George
beautiful.
Lucas.
I yeah. noticed that you had some artwork with you. I was very curious.
Oh,
and I can
sure
see
up.
Why now you're a resident of the Haight-Ashbury for a long time. And the Haight is filled with people who are free thinkers, filled with love, community.
This is Rebecca, this is a simple line drawing of Nancy and I 10 years ago now. It was done in Hawaii, but it incorporates outsider art, rather primitive.
You can catch it if you stick.
Outsider art with some of my visions, the swirling rainbow coming through the waterfall and just the togetherness of it.
And then the waterfall.
And yes, and so here's some examples of some of my whimsical sketches, some of them quite contemporary. There's Kesey.
Ken Kesey.
Yeah, show that one. That's a nice one.
Say where you are, we'll actually get it right here.
And all these years, I never knew you were an artist.
Well, we're all artists, though, you know.
I never knew.
I mean, honestly.
It's wonderful. That's draw as well as you do.
That's part of what you're helping. I'm wishing to express to the generation coming along now.
Right.
I'm not an artist. I'm just who I am. I do what I do, and we so therefore we're all artists.
Yes,
you know?
We are.
I mean, this is very much as Homer Simpson would call it, as one of Wavy from just the recent Earth Day.
If you stay there, we can
2002.
Right there, it's wonderful. I can feel Wavy. It's totally the way Wavy.
That was from Earth Day 2002, the one with Woody Harrelson and that whole crew out of Presidio Park. Today's Earth Day! Happy
oh,
Earth Day,
yes,
everyone!
Happy Earth Day!
This was exactly 2 years ago.
Amazing. Amazing.
That was done. And then these are just friends, Tony Serra.
Oh, wonderful.
Dancing at one of his wonderful parties.
Wonderful.
Other friends. Lovely friends. That's loosely based on charisma, actually.
Cool.
And others, Diane at Tony Serra's party. Now, she's now moving to...
There's you.
There's me, taken by a great photographer named Howard Schatz.
Keep it still, we'll actually.
Folsom Fair 95. So you can see I'm not all fun and games, but pretty much.
Oh, it's great.
Pretty much so. There's the girl that I've stood up today. She may be wandering in any minute now. Lovely Nina, who's quite an artist in her own right. Here's me as various incarnations of modern-day Buddhas.
Wow.
Just playing around and such. And here's me opening the Haight Street Fair, June 12th, 11 a.m. And some special guests this year, certainly, I think. Diamond Dave among them, as always.
He'll be at the Masonic Street stage for everybody.
No, Stanion Street.
Stanion Street stage, sorry.
And these are some artists, other artists and friends.
I'd love to talk to you a little bit about, I heard you have this wonderful newspaper that you hand out called The Waterfallian.
That's right.
And, and if you back up a little bit.
May I give you a copy?
Oh, I'd love one. And if you go back by Izu, I would love to maybe hear something.
Okay, you
want to
read it?
Should I read it or shall I?
Sure, you read some of it if you feel like.
Okay, do you have a copy? We can both do
it. Here's your copy. Just the
thank
one
you. Autographed by Waterfall. Okay. Think Kink. Radio Waterfall's proposal for a new way, the internet.
The internet. Okay, may I?
Yes.
I'm pioneering. I am the Bill Gates of the 22nd century. I'm pioneering the internet. The internet, nothing to subscribe to. Of course, it's a modern unfolding of Jungian's collective unconscious. And I see it as our collective consciousness. What we need now is, for this generation maturing now, we need a nation of bodhisattvas. nation of enlightened people who have the interests of all at heart. Get beyond our frightened ego to our true self, and therefore the artist will emerge on their own. I, in fact, was trained as an engineer, and there are chimps that can do many of the things I was trained to do. So therefore, anybody can be an artist. Just it'll happen. Mm-hmm. But that's a nation of bodhisattvas, a nation of young enlightened leaders to take us out of this wilderness of never-ending strife and war. We don't have to live this way. It is not written anywhere. It's not good. Mm-hmm. We can be secure. We can have a good standard of living without the whole colonial. Am I right?
Absolutely. Well, if you want to read further, pick it up at your local street corner, the Waterfallian.
Thank you very much, Waterfall.
As a
wonderful member of the Haight-Ashbury community, and you as well.
Thank you.
This was wonderful. We learned a lot about you, and I understand why you live here in the Haight, and you've totally added to the flowers in the garden of the Haight-Ashbury.
Thank you.